chilled out with very effective sequence to target the hips. So get yourselves in tabletop, hands tucked underneath your shoulders and your knees underneath your hips. So you breathe in, we're going to step your right foot in between your hands and stay here in this lunge pose. You might, if you've got quite open hips, you can walk that right foot a little bit further forward, just so that right knee stays above that right ankle. Otherwise, keep your foot right where it is and just enjoy the stretch in your glutes, your left frontal hip flexors, and just keep breathing. Cultivate that ujjayi breath here. Try and see your chest lift, so you're not just collapsing onto that right thigh, so you're still quite active through the spine. On your next breath in, right elbow comes to your right thigh, right hand comes to your right thigh, excuse me. Then bring your left hand up to meet it. Keep your legs exactly where they are. Again, softening and relaxing the whole of the lower body. Sometimes it can be really easy just to kind of seize up. When we come into stretches like this, but if we relax in some, they'll be a lot more effective. Take two more breaths here. Allowing gravity just to do its work and relax your hips further down. Let's bring your left hand down onto the mat. Inhale, sweep your right hand up towards the ceiling, trying to stack your shoulders here. Keeping your hips moving down and forward, just in case you get a really nice twist here. On your last exhale, right hand comes down towards the mat. But take your right foot out towards the right hand side of your mat. You turn your toes out maybe by about 45 degrees, so kind of point out about 2 o'clock. You can stay on your palms here in this lizard pose or runner's lunge. And you can make your way down onto your forearms if that feels comfortable for you. Now this is a really juicy stretch of the hips. Trying to remain still here as best as you can. Try not to let your mind take you away with your thoughts. Instead, trying to stay focused on the breath. And count your inhales and count your exhales, that helps you stay focused. Just take 5 more breaths here. Now let's come back up onto our palms. Keeping your left hand on the earth, lift your left foot up towards your left sit bone. See if you take your right hand behind you, take hold of that right pinky toe side of your foot. And if you can't quite reach hold of the foot, you can grab hold of a strap if you've got one, or else a towel or a belt or anything that would do just fine. Just loop it around your back foot so you can hold on to it. Otherwise, taking hold of the little toe side of that left foot. And gaze over your right shoulder here as well, going to a little bit of a twist. Now this is the best pose ever for your head, hip flexors and your quads. Now just enjoying the stretch down through that left side, of the left front of your hip. Gently release your left foot down. Right hand comes back down to the mat, or just comes back to tabletop. And move out your hips if that feels good, just release any tension going on for you there. We'll do all that now onto the left side, so step your left foot in between your hands. Again, adjust your stance, deepen it if you need to. Keep both hands, all 10 fingertips onto the earth. Keep your chest lifting, but at the same time softening and relaxing the whole of your lower body. Now keeping your lower body exactly where it is, add no more tension, don't make any movements. So bring your left hand to your left thigh, bring your right hand up to meet it. Now 5 breaths here. This is called high flying dragon in yin pose, in yin terminology, excuse me. Then bring both hands back down to the mat. Keep your right hand flat onto earth. You breathe in, sweep your left hand up towards the ceiling. Gaze towards that left hand if that feels comfortable for your neck. Keep your hips relaxed. Don't make any movements to your lower body. Exhale as your left hand comes back down. Toe heel your left foot to the left hand side of your mat this time. Toes can point out to about 10 o'clock if that feels comfortable for you. Again, if you stay on your palms, if you're already getting quite a lot of sensation here, absolutely no worries. Or you can start to make your way down to your forearms as well. If you did on the other side, try to do it on this side too. Again, we'll be here for about 5 long breaths. Just trying to remain still, trying to remain present. Your way back in with your hands. Lift your left foot in towards your left sit bone. Send your right foot towards your right sit bone. Send your left hand back. Again, use a strap or a belt or a towel or a dressing gown cord, whatever works to take hold of that foot. Gaze over your left shoulder. Oh, and I should mention, if this place doesn't feel too good for your back knee, your right knee, this is really common. Just place a blanket or something cushiony underneath it just to protect that knee joint. Two more breaths. And then gently release that right foot back down, left hand come back from the mat too. Come to tabletop once again. Good. Let's come into pigeon pose from here. You can come into it from tabletop, or you can, if you prefer, come into it from down facing dog. As I'm trying to make this class a little bit more chilled out, we're going to move into it from tabletop. You can bring your right knee to the base of your right wrist, just on the right hand side of your mat. Bring your right foot more over towards the left hand side of your mat, so your shins are at a diagonal. If you've got really flexible hips, your shin might be at the parallel, but otherwise at diagonal is totally fine as well. First up, walk your left knee back slightly if you want to deepen the pose. Keeping your knee forward slightly, squeeze your knees towards each other to help you kind of stabilize here. Make sure your two hip bones are in line, in a square. Start to walk both hands forwards. Stay on your hands, your forearms, or coming all the way down to your forehead if that's available to you. You'll be here for just about 6 or so breaths. If you want to spend longer in pigeon pose, feel free to press pause. Gently make your way all the way back up onto your hands, lift the head, lift the heart, lift. We're going to move into a variation mermaid pose from here. So you can lift, it's really good hip flexor strengthener and hip flexor opener and quad opener on that left side. So lift your left foot again like we did in our runner's lunge. Keep your left hand on the mat and see if you can take hold of your left foot with your right hand. This may feel like quite a lot for you, so again feel free to use a strap, a towel, anything that will work. And gently release. Step back to tabletop or downward facing dog if you prefer. And we'll take pigeon on the left side, so bring your left knee to your left wrist crease. Cross the shin over. Left foot comes to the right hand side of your mat. Walk your right knee back to deepen the pose only if you want to. Bring your hands to your hip flexors, you draw your knees energetically towards each other to help you stabilise. Make sure that your hip bones are more or less in line. Walk forwards onto your hands, your forearms. Again, all the way down to your forehead if that's available to you. breathe in, place your hands back underneath your shoulders. Lift up, mermaid pose. Kicking up your right foot, lift it in towards your hips, send your left hand back. Again, taking hold of it with a strap or a dressing gown cord, anything that works. Start to draw that right knee into that right foot, right in towards your hips and towards your sit bones. Gently release. Tabletop whenever you're ready. And then we just come down to seated. I got three seated hip openers I want to share with you and possibly a few more. So let's come into square or file of pose first. So you can sit cross-legged and just bring your shins a little bit further out away from your hips. I want your right shin to be in front of that left shin and both shins to be parallel to each other. Almost like you're trying to get opposite foot towards opposite knee. And this is feeling totally okay for you. You can also stack that right shin on top of that left shin. If you've got a huge gap between your right knee and your left ankle, then please don't do this pose. Please keep your shins parallel for each other just for now. Once you're all set up, you start to walk your hands forwards. Now this is a great pose, the TFL, your right outer hip. If you're not feeling it, A, you're crazy, or B, you need to walk your hands a little bit further forward. I personally like, with a lot of my private clients, to have their hands on a block and slowly for them to walk the block away from them as time goes on, just to deepen the pose. Take three more breaths here. And walk both hands all the way back in. We'll place our right foot onto the outside, the other side of your left knee. Bring your left heel towards your right hip. So coming into preparation for Adho Mattasiddhasana twist. Hug your right knee in towards your chest, sit up tall. Then wrap your left inner elbow crease around that right knee. Place your right hand just behind you. Inhale to go tall. Exhale, engage your Ujjayi band as you start to twist over towards the right. Gaze over your right shoulder, only if that feels good for you. Inhale, come back through centre. For the next posture, I would recommend doing this if you can't really, if you're not comfortable here, just miss out this posture. If it feels any discomfort for your knees, just don't do it for yet, and you can work towards it by doing the first two postures. Otherwise, you start to bring your right hip, your right knee, heel, sorry, towards your left hip, coming into cow face pose. So I want both knees to be stacked on top of each other here. Your left heel towards your right hip, your right heel towards your left hip. And now you start to walk your hands forwards. Again, this is really good for the outer hips, for the glutes. It's a really powerful posture. We're just going to do calf face legs here rather than going into the full variation. And bring both hands back through centre. Quickly repeat all that onto the other side. So right shin comes in front, right shin comes behind, left shin comes in front. Make sure that you're going opposite ankle towards opposite knee. Again, if you feel like it's available to you, you can stack that left shin on top of your right. And wherever you're at, start to walk your hands all the way forwards. Again, using that block there as a tool if you want on either. You can also use it front of your forehead if you're quite deep into the posture. Inhale, lift the head, walk your hands back in. Left foot comes to the outside of your right knee. Right heel comes towards your left outer hip. Bring that right inner elbow crease around your left knee. Bring your left hand just behind you. Again, inhale, scrotal. Exhale, twist over towards our left. Deep breathing here. And come back to center in your next breath in. Stack your left knee on top of your right with your left hip coming towards your left heel coming towards your right outer hip. Again, start to work your hands forward. Again, don't do this if it doesn't feel great for your knees. Just work towards them. Come into Baddha Konasana. So just bring soles of your feet to touch, let your knees fall out to the sides. Open the soles of your feet up towards the ceiling. Bring your elbows to the insides of your shins and just start to round the spine down. Bring your head down towards your feet. Again, no worries if your head and your feet don't quite meet. As you know, it's yoga practice, not yoga perfect. We're all working towards something in our yoga practice. Slowly start to come back out. The last posture we will do will be frog pose, which is quite an intense inner thigh slash hip adductor opener. If this doesn't feel great for your knees, feel free to put some cushions or some blankets underneath them. You can walk your knees as far out as is comfortable for you. Bring your feet in line so your ankles and heels are in line with your knees. Make sure that you're not sinking hips too far back or too far forwards. You want them more or less to be in line with your knees. Start to walk your hands forwards. Slightly push your hips a little bit further back if that's comfortable for you, just a little bit. Just notice if you really feel a stretch to your inner thighs. Extend your arms out in front of you if that feels good. Take really deep breaths, trying to remain still and present again. So your hands all the way back in. Slowly, slowly bring your big toes to touch. Bring your knees in towards each other. Come into child's pose just for a moment. And then walk your hands all the way back in. Taking Shavasana if it's time for you to start your practice now. Lying all the way down onto your back. Hug your knees in towards your chest for just a moment. Extend your legs long. Take a rest.